Hi students, this is Kameshwari. My subject watershed management final year first semester. So today we are going to discuss about artificial groundwater recharges. In previous class already we are discussed direct methods. In the direct methods, surface methods are completed, and going to discuss subsurface methods. Water subsurface method. So aim that recharging deep water aquifers impact structures commonly used are injection wells or recharge wells, recharge pits, recharge shafts and subsurface dikes. So injection wells, figure shows the injection wells. So similar to be tube pumped in treated surface water under pressure, confined aquifer, little land required. Okay, what's that? Injection well similar to tube wells. So pumping in thread surface water under pressure, confined aquifer, little land required. Figure shows the injection wells here required. One pipe is injected into the ground, so some of the water will be from atmosphere to ground. Rains comes from the atmosphere to ground, that is in the form of a precipitation. So due to that permeability, water will be infiltrate into the ground surface. So natural recharge from precipitation, some of the water infiltrate into the ground surface, and natural recharges and the remaining water will be stagnate on a ground surface. And continuous artificial recharge means from injection of pipe and also bedrock. Due to that, water will be flows from injection pipe. The remaining water will be injected from the pipe. And recharge pits. Wells means a filter bed. It consists of one filter bed also. So filter bed consists of sand and gravel. And also combination of a borehole is drilled to about 2 to 3 meters below the water table. A perforated casing pipe of 20 mm diameter is placed inside the hole, and the space between the hole and the pipe is filled with gravel. The runoff water flows through the filter bed. Recharge pits. What is meant by recharge pits? Recharge pits are built of varying shapes. That is rectangular, square or circular with diameters 1 to 2 meters width and 2 to 3 meters depth. It is meant for replacement groundwater by recharging of shallow aquifers. The pits are filled with boulders at the bottom layer, gravel as the medium layer and coarse sand as the top layer. The silt following along with the runoff water gets deposited on the top of the coarse sand layer. If the recharge pits is used to recharge a borewell, then it should be constructed in closed borewell. It should be built in areas with perfectly quick infiltration and percolation ability. So excavated of various diameters in deep. One side is clay, another side also clay, permeable materials. So water table will be increased. If clay layer is encountered while constructing a recharge pit, then a deep hole of 5 meters deep is dug and filled with gravel of 3 to 6 meters in size. The top portion of the recharge pit is covered with a perforated cover to allow water to pass through the holes into the pit. And another one is recharge shaft. Recharge shaft. So recharge drainage method of groundwater recharge has resemble with sub irrigation method to avoid intrusion with the surface land use. In this method, the surface runoff or the reclaimed water flows to a network perforated drainage conducts designed to recharge shallow aquifers, small in cross section, fast recharge. These are embedded in stone filled trenches and meant to carry rainwater, stormwater from the catchment harvesting system to replacement the potable aquifers, and also subsurface dikes. What is meaning of subsurface dikes? So these subsurface dikes are a barrier impermeable to water. Underground PVC sheets, local well defined, wide, greatly sloping valley, no evaporation loss. The figure shows the subsurface dikes and subsurface drainage collection with wells. In this method, subsurface drainage collector are used along with the wells for groundwater recharge. Water from the basin infiltrate into the soil. This water is collected by horizontal drainage place between the basin and the impermeable zone. The percolated water flows into the drains, which then flows into the well located below the zone of low permeability. And also indirect methods. Water pumps pumped from aquifer hydraulically. Reverse gradient formed when poor quality of surface water. So aquifer modification. Common methods: bore blasting, hydrofracking, jacket well techniques, fracture seal syndication. Hydrofracturing method. Water injected at high pressure to widen existing fracture of rock. In this method, poor yielding and dry bore wells are treated by applying hydraulic pressure. Dry bore wells are treated by applying hydraulic pressures. That is, by sending high pressure water into the bore wells. The high water pressure causes the opening up of the closed sealed fracture or create new fractures that interconnects the aquifer at various levels. To increase the porosity for the inflow of water from the water bodies. So this can be the high water pressure causes the opening up of the closed or sealed fractures or create new fractures that interconnects the aquifers at various levels. And case study. To enhance the water table, improve the quality of water in open dug wells. Rooftop harvesting, sand filters, simple method, and rooftop harvesting ordinary nylon filters. So this is economical and also aquifer modifications are bore blasting. Another one is advantages of aquifers: enhanced yield of wells and hand pumps, improve water quality, no adverse effects like large surface area and loss of crops, no displacement of local population. And also one more thing, blasting is also there. Blasting, bore blasting method. In this method, the cycling rocks are blasted by sending a slurry explosive through the boreholes situated deep underground. It is connected to a detonating cord and electrical detonators. The high pressure waves formed due to explosion causes fracture in the rocks to increase the water recharge and thus storage area aquifers. So these are the aquifers modifications and also artificial recharge of groundwater methods. So finally, the conclusion: artificial recharge products are designed to replace groundwater resource. Proper storage and management of available groundwater resource is essential.